My name's Catherine, I'm 34 years old and I'm from Ingleby Barwick in Stockton. I'm married to Anthony, he's 42. He does everything, the cooking, the cleaning. He'll dry my hair for me while I'm watching telly. He'll dye my eyebrows. He is perfect.
Catherine and Anthony had a quirky winter wedding in Northumberland.
We actually got married in a treehouse. We wanted something completely different to your traditional weddings.
And when it came to choosing an unusual dress to match her venue, Catherine knew this blush pink gown was the one.
The minute I actually seen this dress, I completely fell in love with it. I did feel like a princess. All the lights were shining on it. It just looked beautiful. As soon as Anthony seen me walking down the aisle, he started to cry. If he hadn't have started crying, I might have turned back round and left. I would love my dress to have a second chance.
Hi, Catherine.
Hi.
Come on in.
It's not really about the money for me. I just want to see somebody else love it as much as I did.
Come sit down, get comfy. So tell us a little bit about your wedding day.
I got married in a treehouse in November.
It's really cool.
To start with, I wanted to get married just me and my husband, nobody else. But he wanted the family there, so that's why I chose something a little bit different.
You guys sound quite similar in that way.
So that makes me hopeful.
Yeah.
I feel like me and Catherine have a lot in common. The fact that she's similar to me makes me think that we're going to like the same sort of dress. Oh! Wow.
Oh, my goodness.
My heart's going really fast. Yeah.
Is it?
Yeah, I really like it. Yeah. You've got a great taste. Yeah. I've not seen many dresses where I've gone, wow.
Yeah.
And that does make you go, wow.
I can't believe Penny's reaction to this dress. It has bling. If Penny saw that dress in a wedding shop, she wouldn't have even gone near it.
This dress is slightly lower at the back, but it's not completely backless. I don't know if that would be a deal breaker.
Yeah. Just have to see. So it feels a little bit big up top, I think, but around sort of my hips and that, it feels quite figure-hugging. It feels quite good, actually.
What do you think about the dress?
I think it's beautiful. My only reservation is that it's not backless.
Oh, wow.
Oh, my goodness.
It's beautiful.
That is so pretty.
So pretty. Wow. So, Penny, how do you feel in this one? Tell me what you love.
The colour, the shape, and actually, I think the back is quite good. You can see most of my tattoos.
You can.
Yeah. I think she looks gorgeous in it. Honestly, do you not? Yeah, it's beautiful.
I hope it's brutally honest. So for her to say something like that is pretty good.
Shall we talk about price? What did you pay for the dress originally?
£2,000.
Oh. And what did you want to sell it for?
Around £800.
Yeah, it's quite a lot of money.
What sort of price are you looking to pay, Penny?
£400. But I think I need to get it altered as well. I've no idea how much that'll cost.
I'd go down to £500.
This dress search is so tough because it's not just about falling in love with the gown. It's about being on budget, including alterations, so that Penny has maximum funds for her travels with her hubby-to-be. Choosing the right wedding dress should come from the heart, but Penny's budget is playing a huge factor in her final decision. Will she give any of my picks a second chance to go down the aisle? So we'll start with Simone's dress.
See, that's
so pretty.
A stunning picture.
That photo does look good, but when it was on, it just didn't feel right.
No.
Yeah.
Next up, we've got Catherine's dress.
I really like it.
It's just gorgeous on you.
Is there anything that's putting you off about it?
Probably the price, because it's above my budget.
Next up, we have Alex's dress. The price on this one was the best of all four, £300.
It is good value.
I think it's a really pretty dress.
Yeah, detail's amazing on it.
It really did show off your tattoo.
OK, so lastly, we have the wild card.
Oh, no, I don't think it's for me.
So, are you going to give one of these dresses a second chance?
Catherine's dress has the element of glitz and glam, but Alex's dress is the best of both worlds, traditional and edgy.
Catherine's dress.
Catherine's dress?
Yeah. But on one condition. I need to get the price down.
Ooh, right. Mm. This is a risky move. Catherine has already reduced the dress from £2,000 down to
£500. Hi. I absolutely love your dress and I'd like to buy it.
Oh, amazing.
But the price is a little bit too high for me because I'm going to have to get it altered as well. So, would you be willing to sell it to me for £250?
Probably not.
How low would you go?
£500, that was probably my lowest figure.
OK.
But I'd go down to the four for your budget.
£400,
yeah.
OK, that's still too high for me, Catherine, but thank you anyway.
No problem.
She didn't buy it.
I completely understand, but then also I've got more important things I need to spend my money on.
So is this the final decision?
Yeah, we're going to say no, yeah.
I've loved having you all here. You're all amazing. And there's a phone ringing.
Yeah, yeah.
The phone's ringing.
The phone's ringing.
Who is it?
Oh. Hi, Catherine.
Oh, my God.
Hi. Hi. Yeah.
To my husband, and it would be a shame for you not to wear it, so if you really love it, then we'll drop down to three.
That's amazing!
Catherine, you're amazing!
I can't believe it, I've got my dream dress and at a bargain. Really appreciate it. It'll be loved, I promise you.
Penny has a wedding dress.
I know.
The one she loves, yeah. The wow dress.
Yeah.
I've got a dress!
You've got this dress!
I love the dress. It's absolutely breathtaking. I couldn't have wished for anything better.